torque the ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Second down, back to Edwards-Helaire. He takes this for 3 to the 29.
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
The Jets will bring in a nickel set as they try to stop this third down. Now Mahomes. Gonna let one fly for Robinson. A fight for it, and this is caught. It's caught indeed. Defender was right there in his shorts. Is that one of those situations as a DB where you just tip your cap and say, nice catch?
Well, you're supposed to, but a true competitor, he's not tipping his cap at all. He's upset he still didn't make the play. If it's a 50-50 ball or a moment of truth, he's got to win more than his fair share of them as well.
Probably especially angry because if it was incomplete, would have been fourth down.
Exactly.
So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Here we go again. Here we go again. He'll look to throw. On the slant, he's got Hardman. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense could get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here. And now they're set up for the first and goal.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll run with Edwards-Helaire. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. 133 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. Again, Edwards-Helaire, and he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Clyde Edwards-Helaire, his second touchdown of the afternoon, and the Chiefs have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. So it was the passing game that got him down here, but closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive. Nice change up there going to the running game to get him over the goal line.
Andy Reid, never one to shy away from taking chances. He'll go for 2. And here's Edwards-Helaire. And he will get into the end zone again. And he seems to have a nose for it as he gets both the touchdown and the 2-point conversion. And so they run it in on the 2-point try. And so often, Charles, we talk about from the offense's perspective what you do on the 2-point conversion. How about the defense? How do they play run versus pass?
It's really difficult for them because I think most teams want to play for the pass. That's what they see most teams do. And so are you able to mass enough people inside if the team decides to run it? Very difficult. I think what you're seeing a lot more now, people blitzing the 2-point conversion. They want you to make a quick decision and make it right now.
There, the offense wins the battle for 2. And it's a pretty good return here as they get this up to the 29. Here's the Jets offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. And last time the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. Maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook, one play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a let.
Pressure comes and Wilson's going to go down. CD, but I don't think anybody really was fooled. All eyes were fixated on the quarterback, and they got him to the ground.
And to run this play successfully, you've got to make sure that everyone is doing their part. You actually have to sell this play. You've got to sell the run action. Otherwise, why do you stop at the running back? You just run straight for the quarterback and put him on the ground.
Throwing on second and long. Wilson, his throw incomplete. Johnson, the intended target, but now it'll be third down. Now Wilson. And he's taken down, a cheap sack. Boy, Charles, that time he took a bad situation and made it worse.
Yeah, you're almost putting together a nice little song there, aren't you? Because it's something you'll see from young quarterbacks. They have that tendency to retreat backwards instead of stepping up in the pocket.
Here's the Jets punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Here's Hardman to return. Just a net of 31 here, 40-yard punt, 9 on the return. And the Chiefs will have excellent field position here as they take over. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Did they stick with it?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Edwards-Helaire as they run out of the gun. They get them a little over half of what they need, and now they're looking at a third and 5.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
The gun on third down, Mahomes. To the right side, it's Kelce. And he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. It goes as a gain of 8 that moves the chains.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
And they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Throw. There goes a deep ball. End zone. And that'll be caught. Touchdown Kansas City. DeMarcus Robinson. 34 yards. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead. The fly route works for the TD Graham.
And you know what the receivers love to say? If we get even with the defender, we're leaving. And that's exactly what he did, all the way into the end zone. And then he was on the business end, catching it once he got over the stripe.
Now Mahomes to the line as the Chiefs are going to go for the two-point try. Mahomes will throw for it. And he's got it. So the try for two, successful. And that bumps their lead up even further. And the formula there on the two-point try, they go 5 wide, not even the option to hand the ball off. They got it.
They tried to create space, and there isn't a whole lot of it there. For the defense, what you're trying to do is make sure that someone, if they're going to catch the ball, make them catch it behind you because they run out of space with the back line. But in this case, the offense figured it out.
On the return, Corey Ballantyne. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. The New York set to take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what Al Davis fumbles it. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. And you've probably talked about this training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. On second down now, it's Coleman. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. Give him 12 yards there, and the Jets have a first.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
Scrimmage, and he goes down right there. A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but one of the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. A Jet first down, 18 big yards that time.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender, and that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
First and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 38. Hand off, Coleman, right side. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. A full 5-yard loss that time. It's going to make second down pretty tough.
You got to figure the further they fall behind, the more you think that they'll get away from the run. They're trying to stick with it, but the results, they just aren't there.
Still 15 yards to go, second down. There's Wilson to throw. He's got Herndon, his tight end. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Let's not quibble about the game there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Great end. Touchdown, New York. Corey Davis, 35 yards. And the Jets are able to cut into this deficit.
And remember, partner, that's a rookie quarterback back there. Apparently, he's getting the hang of this NFL thing pretty quickly.
And 3 touchdown passes. You're right. He looks comfortable. What are they doing? Anything in particular?
Well, they keep talking about making sure they're giving him plays that fit his talents. And also maybe shrinking the playbook a little bit. They did tell us that. Bottom line, he's really good.
Extra Bryant splits the uprights, and this is back to an 8-point game. Now Ficken to kick off following the touchdown. Takes it at the 7. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Out comes Patrick Mahomes in the Chiefs' offense. He's been pretty solid, pretty consistent. Just the one touchdown pass, but I think he's managed the game well, no?
I would agree with you, and that's what you're looking for out of your field leader. Making sure that you're playing well and not making any big mistakes. Oftentimes, that's how you're judged. How big a mistake and when it occurs. No interception so far. They'll like that.
I just want you to know that you agreeing with me, that's going to get me through this third and fourth quarter. Are you touched? He's patting his heart, boys and girls. He's touched.
Respect.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. It away and it falls down incomplete. He was trying to get that to Edwards and Lair out of the backfield, and that'll make it 3rd down. Working from the gun, Mahomes gonna let one fly for Robinson, and at the 7-yard line, the catch is made, and oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
Well, Bart, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they put field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
After the big play, a chance to finish now on 1st and goal. Try to run with Edwards Alaire. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Clyde Edwards Alaire taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Chiefs get another 3rd quarter touchdown to add on to that lead. He keeps carrying the ball into the end zone. And in this one, he's sort of carrying the team on his back.
He's the reason that they lead right now. No question about it. And you talk about on his back, he's not minding the extra weight at all, is he? Carrying that just as lightly as he does the football. And what a great performance so far.
Those 3 touchdowns, it's got him in the lead. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead is up to 15 now. After the touchdown, here's Bunker on to kick it away. Ballantyne to return. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. New York's offense back out there and set to go. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Now Wilson on 1st down. He's got Cole on the slant. There he goes, right side. Right in. Touchdown, New York. Keelan Cole with his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Jets are able to get a score back in the final stages of this 3rd quarter.
So what about a rookie quarterback taking time to adjust to life in the NFL? Because this guy looks like he's been doing it for about, 7 years? 4 touchdown passes? That's not something rookies are supposed to be doing with the ease in which he's doing it.
Extra point right down the middle. And this is back to an 8-point game. They certainly made quick work of that, ultra quick work. One of the fastest drives you'll ever see. Just one play resulting in the touchdown. Now Ficken to kick off following the touchdown. Fielded right around the 8. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
And he continues to pile up the yardage. That puts him over a 150 now. And this defense has really had his problems trying to keep him contained.
And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down. Shotgun snap, and again to Edwards-Helaire. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. Edwards-Helaire. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with 3rd and 5.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Quarter, Charles, you really emphasized the importance of winning the turnover battle as a visiting team, as an underdog. They haven't forced a single turnover in this game.
And right now they're losing, so no turnovers might lead to no victory.
Here's the Chiefs punter now, as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. Just 1 yard on the return. And the Jets offense will be backed up to start this drive as they've got it 1st and 10. Back on offense, New York gets set to take over. And it feels like the momentum has shifted. They scored, then their defense forces that last punt. And now a chance to tie the game on this possession. On 1st and 10, it's Wilson. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Coleman. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2. First play of the drive in their hip pocket. Of course, the focus here has to be the touchdown and the 2-point conversion. Field goals aren't going to help you.
Yeah, but how about that first play of the drive? Just to get them started, nice game, got some positive momentum going. They're on their way, and they don't have to rush.
Pressure comes, and Wilson's going to go down. It has been a rough afternoon for him trying to get rid of the football. See, that's now 5 sacks.
I'd like to be the offensive coordinator, the offensive line coach, trying to come up with an answer for this pass rush. What blocking assignments do you change? Can guys play a little bit better? And we're seeing the end result on the scoreboard. Long day in the pocket,
third down, Wilson. On the catch, it's Crowder. And they're going to stop him short of the first down as he's tackled at about the 21. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. On is the punter man as he boots this one away. Hardman on a return. So a good punt, but a solid 12-yard return. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. And Kansas City's offense now set, ready to go. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their 38. The drive will begin with a run by Edwards-Helaire. And muscle his way up to the 43 for a pickup of right around 5. Oh, that's going to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut. So up through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. Now the Georgia Southern man, this is Jarek McKinnon. They follow up the gain of 5 by only getting 1 there on second down.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
Mahomes looks to throw on third down. And look at this. They get the target they needed. It's intercepted. Marcus Joyner with a pick. And the return across midfield.